What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Today I want to talk a little bit about something that hits real close to home. I really think it's one of the most important things, not just in fitness, but in life in general. I'm talking about consistency. It's so important, it's so key. It's something that everybody should improve on, myself especially. It's really boils down to being one of the most important things in every corner of life. So I want to give some of my thoughts about it. Consistency, consistency, consistency. You would have a very difficult time convincing me that anything is more important in working your way towards success. You know, whether it's fitness, whether it's any goal that you have in life, it all boils down to being consistent. And that means consistent in your mindset, consistent in the amount of work you're willing to put in, consistent in the amount of time you're willing to dedicate to your goal. It's so important, it can't be ignored. And there's so much that goes into consistency. Probably two of the biggest things would be motivation, keeping your motivation strong so that you have the drive to stick with your pursuit of your goal, as well as organization, which is really strategizing, planning your path to success, your path to hitting this goal that you've set for yourself, or these goals. You know, I'm sure we have multiple, not just a single goal. And really, when we think about motivation, when we think about organization, these are things you have to put work into to develop as skills. You know, speaking from my own experience, they're not something that everyone is necessarily born with. Some people are. Some people are very fortunate to have one or the other. Sometimes people have both, and that's sort of an extraordinary circumstance because everyone has to work at these traits, but I think there's some of the most important traits to work at. So motivation. I talked about a little bit in my last video about getting up at 2:30 every morning and starting the day early and really trying to cram as much into every day as possible. And getting up that early is very difficult for a lot of people to even consider, you know, myself included a few months back. Because it just doesn't seem realistic. And I like to challenge that. I like to challenge myself to put aside those conventions, put aside what is expected as being reasonable, expected as being normal or average. Because I don't want to be normal. I don't want to be average. I want to be me. I want to pursue my goals, my dreams. I want to build towards a future that excites me, that makes me happy. So my motivation is looking towards tomorrow. It's not about, you know, today in the moment now and setting that alarm for 2:30 tomorrow morning. I'm thinking about a year from now, 5 years from now, 50 years from now. And it's a process. It's a slow build over time. Because I don't believe in overnight successes. I don't believe in luck. I believe in work. And yeah, there are days where it's hard to motivate myself, or I'm sure to motivate yourself, but those are the days you really have to stick with it. You have to remember why you started. Remember that why, that what really gave you a kick in the ass to get moving on whatever you're working towards. You know, why did you join a gym? Why did you reach out to whomever on Instagram or whomever at your local gym for advice? Why, what gave you that motivation? That's what you need to keep in the back of your mind, because some days it's gonna be easy, some days it's gonna be a breeze and you're working hard and it feels good and you're happy and it comes naturally to you. But some days it's gonna be an all out struggle. And that's not something to be scared about, that's something to brace for, something to prepare yourself for, something to attack head on. Because there's no other way to go around it. You can't avoid those challenging circumstances. You have to embrace them and become stronger as a result of them. And that's what motivation means to me. And you may get 100 different opinions or definitions on what motivation means from, you know, for 100 different experts, 100 different, you know, people you know, your mom, your friends. Everyone may have a different interpretation of it, but that's mine, and that's helped me so greatly that I can't even actually put that into words. And motivation is very mental. It's very mindset oriented, psychological. Organization, however, is some of those things as well. So psychological, but it's more practical, it's more physical, it's more strategic. What are you going to do to work towards your goal? Now, this can be difficult for a lot of people when you don't really know a lot about that pursuit. Like for fitness, as an example, a lot of people don't know where to begin in the gym, and that's why there are hundreds, thousands of trainers, of experts, of fitness gurus who want to sell you something, with more genuine intentions, want to help you, want to share their knowledge. And it's difficult to root through who has what intentions, but when you find someone of knowledge who can share some of that with you and help you work towards your goal, that's how you become organized. And that may be someone else helping you work towards that in some instances, but others, it's solely on your shoulders. But there's no trainer who can explain to you the best way to allot time during your day to go work out. That has to come from you. You have to plan your life around your goal. And it doesn't mean you have to eat, sleep, and breathe fitness if you're just looking to lose 10 pounds or to slim down for the summer. But if something means something to you, you have to alter your routine to allow yourself to pursue that goal. There's no way around it. There's no easy fix. Sometimes it means getting up at 2:30 in the morning, because for me, that's more organization than it is motivation. Because I know I'm not going to be able to work on what I want to work on unless I create those extra hours during my day, during every day. I'm willing to create those hours because, logistically speaking, they're not gonna be there if I sleep in. So that's me organizing my day to allow for something that means the most, means a lot to me. And that's JMD Fitness. That's what, I have time to work out. Anyone who works full time and has a relationship or has a family, you have time to work out. I don't know who you're kidding. You may not be at that point yet, but when you look at the numbers, when you look at the amount of hours in a day, you have time if you care to make time. But for JMD Fitness, this second job, this project that means so much to me, that's so important to me, I have to bend over backwards to make enough time to simply get it started, to make YouTube videos, to make Instagram videos, to edit everything, to make a website, to make plans for clients. It means the world to me. So I'm happy to organize my day, organize my life, and allow time for this, because it's for you, it's for the clients, it's for the beginners in the gym, it's for the experienced people, it's for related fitness minds, but it's really for me, because it's what I enjoy, it's what I'm passionate about, it's what I have to share, it's the knowledge I have to share, it's it brings me happiness in a way that other things couldn't. So that's why it's important for me to design my day and to allot time for this goal. And I talk about the motivation that drives me to work on creating JMD Fitness. I talk about the organization, what actually goes into the logistics of fitting it into my life. And again, those things combined equal consistency. If you take care to be aware of those two components, you work on your consistency. And I am very much in the process of practicing what I'm preaching right now with this whole JMD Fitness project, because I recognize full well that there aren't too many people who care right now about my message or hearing my message from me. This is the beginning, and I don't claim to be the number one expert on everything fitness or everything nutrition or everything Instagram or everything YouTube. It's some of it's new, some of it's, you know, it's an experience for me, but all of it is geared towards providing as much value to you as I can. So I'm not in it for me. I'm not in it for attention. I don't need to be patted on the back. I've been working out for 3.5 years now because I love it, because I love the challenge, because it makes me feel better about me. And I'm so amazed at how it's changed my life that I can't sleep at night if I don't bust my butt to try and share that change, try to share that joy and confidence boost with someone else. And if I have to make 1,000 YouTube videos and post on Instagram 5 times a day until the day I die just to change one person's life, or just to change one person's outlook and give them motivation or help them plan to get better, then I'm okay with that. Because this is bigger than me. This is not about, I got in good shape, so look at me. This is about helping others. And I believe I've been uniquely gifted a way to do that. And now it's a matter of my consistency. It's a matter of me not getting down because I don't have the reach I want to have, or people aren't hearing what I'm saying, or people scroll through their feed too quick to look at the exercises I'm suggesting. I can't get down about that. I have to stay consistent because I know my intentions are pure, and I know that in time, if I practice what I preach and if I work my ass off, in time I will be able to help people. And maybe that doesn't come until I'm looking like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Maybe no one wants to hear me until I look the part a little bit more. And that's okay. That's coming too. You know, that's something I want for me. And you know, if the better physique makes people more willing to listen, then whatever. I'll take advantage of that. I'm going to get through to people. I'm going to help people because there's no way for me not to. There's no way I can sleep at night. There's no way I can rest easy sitting on this passion, sitting on this fire that's burning in me and not sharing it with the world. And it's consistency. The world doesn't care right now. The world doesn't care about JMD Fitness. That doesn't scare me. That doesn't discourage me. That motivates me. That empowers me. That fuels me to work harder, to be more relatable, to be more helpful, to bring more value. And I'll work and I'll work and I'll sacrifice sleep and I'll educate myself further on the best way to communicate, and I'll get better. And over time, I will start to help people more. And I've been blessed to have real personal training jobs to show me just how important this passion is to me. To be able to work with people one-on-one was a great gift to me because it helped me to forge those personal connections, those personal relationships, and be able to communicate effectively. Now, using social media, using the internet, I know there's so many more people I can help. And again, if I gotta look like Arnold to get people to listen, then guess what? I'm gonna fucking look like Arnold. It's gonna happen. So I wanna give an unbelievable amount of thanks to every single person who's supporting me at this stage in this endeavor, a few months in, for people to care right now, for people I've known from the past, you know, from high school, from Planet Fitness in Belchertown, from, you know, moving to Connecticut, for everyone who's helped me stay motivated, for everyone who's given me a little bit of love and a little bit of support. It means the world to me. And I don't say it at the end of my videos just because I think it sounds good. I mean it. And you guys really are the very first people I want to help, if you'll let me. Any questions you have, any comments, concerns, suggestions for what you want to see, I'm making this content for you, whether you recognize it or not right now. It's about you. So help me to deliver the best product to you, to interest you, to show you something you want to see. Because I'm going to keep making the content one way or another. It's too much of a drive for me now to stop. So please let me know if you have, you know, an idea of something you want to be explained, or if you want me to stop doing something too. How can I make this channel better? How can I make Instagram better? How can I be more useful, more helpful, and more valuable? Let me know. And every like and comment and follow and, you know, hit of the subscribe button means the world to me. But more, even more than that, is you guys taking the time to listen to what I have to say. It's truly special for me, and it's a learning experience for me. And that's why I'm so curious to hear what you're thinking. It's been a few months, so if you've been hesitant about reaching out, please do. I'm waiting. And as always, please do like and subscribe. But more importantly, share with a friend, or take the time to think about what you want to see. Female, male, beginner, experienced, let me know. Let me know what would be useful for you, what you think would be useful for others. I appreciate it, guys. I really do. Thanks.